जय हिंद ऑल ऑफ यू। आई एम प्रोफेसर पी एम पाटिल, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ एग्रोनॉमी, के ऑफ कॉलेज ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर, नासिक। टुडे वी डिस्कस ऑन स्टडी ऑफ एफिशिएंट क्रॉपिंग सिस्टम एंड अलाइड एंटरप्राइजेस। एफिशिएंट क्रॉपिंग सिस्टम फॉर पर्टिकुलर फार्म डिपेंड ऑन फार्म रिसोर्सेस, एंटरप्राइजेस एंड फार्म टेक्नोलॉजी, बिकॉज फार्म इज एन ऑर्गेनाइज इकोनॉमिकल यूनिट। फार्म रिसोर्सेस इंक्लूड land, labor, water, capital and infrastructure. When land is limited, intensive cropping is adapted to fully utilize available water and labor. When sufficient and cheap labor available, vegetable crops are also included in cropping system as they required more labor. Capital intensive crop like sugarcane, banana, turmeric, etc. find a space in a cropping system when capital is not a constraint. In low rainfall region where 750 mm per annum monocropping is followed and when rainfall is more than 750 mm, intercropping is practiced. With sufficient irrigation water, triple and quadruple cropping is adopted when other climatic factors are not limiting. Farm enterprises like dairy, poultry, etc. also influence the type of cropping system. On the basis of country may be divided broadly into five agriculture regions. The rice region extending from the eastern part to include a very large part of the northeastern and the southeastern India with another strip along the western coast. The wheat region occupying most of the northern, western and central India. The millet sorghum region comprising Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh and the Deccan Plateau in the center of the Indian Peninsula. And the temperate Himalayan region of Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh and Uttar Pradesh and also some adjoining areas. Here potatoes are the important as a cereal crops, which mainly maize and rice and the tree fruits from the large part of agriculture production. The plantation crop region of Assam and the hills of the southern India where good quality tea is produced. There is an important production of high quality coffee in the hill of the western peninsular India. Rubber is mostly grown in Kerala and part of Karnataka and Tamil Nadu. There are some large estates, but most of the growers would come under the category of small holders. Sugarcane, which in many countries is the plantation crop, is almost entirely grown by small holder. Then cattle rearing. Cattle rearing in India is carried out under the variety of climatic and environmental conditions. The cattle are broadly classified into three groups. Draft breed. The bullocks of these breeds are good draft animal, but the cows are poor milkers. Example, Nagori, Hallikar, Kangiyan, Mali. Dairy breeds. The cows are high milk yielders, but the bullocks are of poor draft quality. Example, Sahiwal, Sindhi and Gir. Dual purpose, these cows are fairly good milker and their bullocks are with good draft work capacity. For example, Haryana, Hungar and Kankrej. Exotic breed, the exotic breeds are high milk yielders. For example, Jersey, Holstein Friesian, Ayrshire, Brown Swiss and Garsini. Buffalo. Important dairy breeds of buffalo are Murrah, Nili Ravi, Mehsana, Suti, Jafrabadi, Godavari and Badavari. Housing. Each cow require 12 to 18 square meter space and buffalo needs 12 to 15 square meter. It is important to provide good ventilation and an open shed of housing is always preferable. Dairy building should be located at an elevated place to facilitate easy drainage. Breeding and maintenance. This part also complete in feeding. Cattle feed generally contains fibrous cores and low nutrient straw material called roughages and concentrate. In roughages, dairy cattle are efficient use of roughages and convert large quantities of relatively inexpensive roughages into milk. Roughages are basic for cattle ration and include legumes, non-legumes, hay, straw and silage of legumes and grasses. Concentrate grains and byproducts of grains and oilseeds constitute the concentrate. They are extensively used in dairy cattle region. These include cereal, cotton seeds, industrial waste of wheat, rice, gram husk, and cake of oil seeds. Vitamins and mineral mixtures. It is advisable to feed a supplement containing vitamins A and D. Mineral mixture containing salt, calcium, and phosphorus should also be provided in addition. Goat rearing. In India, activity of goat rearing is sustained in different kinds of environment, including dry, hot, wet, and cold, high mountains or low lying plains. The activity is also associated with different systems such as crop or animal base, pastoral and sedentary, single animal or mixed herd, small or large scale. Goat is mainly reared for meat and milk, hide and skin. In breed, there are nearly 102 breeds of goats in the world, of which 20 breeds are in India. According to purpose, following are important breeds in India. First, milk and meat purpose. Osmanabadi, Barberi, Jamnapari, Sangamneri, Mehsana, Jalodi, etc. Then meat purpose, Assam, Kali Bengali, Brown Bengali and Marwari. Then wool purpose, Angora, Gadi and Mina. Then housing, goat can be maintained under stall feed conditions. Successful goat rearing depends on the selection of site. Goats do not thrive on marshy or swampy ground. Goats are to be provided with a dry, comfortable, safe and secure place, free from worms and affording protection from excessive heat and inclement weather. The kits are kept under large inverted basket until they are old enough to run along with their mother. Then breeding and feeding also explained in previous chapter. Then sheep rearing, breeds of Indian sheep. There are three types of sheep in India based on the geographical division of the country. The dry temperature, Himalayan region, Gurez, Karana, Bhakrawar, Gadi, Rampur, Bushir. Then dry western region, Lohi, Bikaneri, Marwari, Kukki, Kathiawari. Southern region, Deccani, Nellore, Bellary, Mandya and Bandur. Then breeding and maintenance. One ram can be maintained for 40 to 50 ewes. Rams are liable to fight when two or more of them are put in the pen. Unlike other farm animals, ewes in general do not come in heat at regular interval throughout the year, but are seasonal in this respect. The duration of heat period will range from 1 to 3 days and 75% of ewes remain in heat for 21 to 39 hours. The gestation period will vary from 142 to 152 days with average 147 days. Then feeding, a sheep required about 1 to 2 kg of leguminous hay per day depending on the age of sheep and its body weight. The proteins may be supplied through concentrates such as groundnut cake, sesame cake, or safflower cake. When the pasture are poor in legumes or when scarcity conditions prevail. Poultry, its breed also discussed in previous housing. Adequate space should be provided for the bird. Floor area about 0.2 meter square per adult bird is adequate for light breed such as white leghorn. About 0.3 to 0.4 meter square per bird is required for heavy breeds. Feeds. The feed conversion efficiency of the bird is far superior to the other animals. About 60 to 70% of the total expenditure on poultry farming is spent on the poultry feed. Then maintenance. The chick must be vaccinated against chronic head disease with F1 strain vaccine within the first 6 to 7 days of the then hens may be retained for the 1 year of the production up to age 1.5 years. After that, they are disposed of for table purpose. Beekeeping. Beekeeping is the one of the most important agro-based industry which does not require raw material from the artisan like other industries. Nectar and pollen from the flowers are the raw materials which are available in plenty in the nature. Species. There are two species, Apis serena and Apis mellifera, are complementary to each other but have different adaptations. Apis serena is the better acclimatized to the higher altitude of the Himalayan region. Apis mellifera is the more profitable in the plains. In management, the beekeeper should be familiar with the source of nectar and pollen within his locality. The most important source of the nectar and pollen are maize, great millet, bulrush, sunflower and palm. The beginner should start with 2 and not more than 5 colonies. The minimum of 2 colonies is recommended because in the event of some mishap such as loss of the queen occupying in one, advantages may be taken with the other. Honey collection. Honey should have good quality to meet the national and international standards. Quality such as aroma, color, consistency and floral sources are important. Proper honey staining and processing are needed to improve the quality of the produce. Honey is an excellent energy food with an average of the about 3500 calories per kg. It is directly absorbed into the human blood stream, required no. Then mushroom cultivation. Mushroom is an edible fungi with great diversity in shape, size and color. Essentially, mushroom is an vegetable that is cultivated in protected farms in a high sanitized atmosphere. Just like other vegetables, mushroom contain 90% moisture with high in quality protein. Types of mushroom. Oyster mushroom, milky mushroom and button mushroom. Biogas plant. Biogas is a clean, unpolluted and cheap source of energy which can be obtained by a simple mechanism and little investment. The gas is generated from the cow dung during anaerobic decomposition. Biogas generation is a complex biochemical process. Types of biogas plant. Float, dome type. Different models are available in the category. For example, KVIC, vertical and horizontal, Pragati model, Ganesh model. Fixed dome type. The gas plant is dome shaped underground construction. The Mizorni gas holders is an integral part of the digester called dome. The gas produced in digester collected in dome at vertical pressure by displacement of slurry in the inlet or outlet. Size: the size of biogas plant is decided by the number of family members and their availability of cattle. 1 cubic meter capacity plant will need 2 to 3 animals and 25 kg of dung. Site selection and management: the site should be close to the kitchen or the place of the use. It will reduce the cost of gas distribution system. It should also be nearer to the cattle shed to reduce the cost of transportation of cattle dung. Land should be leveled and slightly above the ground level to avoid inflow or runoff water. Plant should get clear sunshine during the most part of the day. Gas production would be maximum at a temperature between 30 to 35 degrees Celsius. If the ambient temperature fell below 10 degrees Celsius, gas production is reduced drastically. Biogas slurry is obtained after the production of biogas. It is an enriched manure. Another positive aspect of this manure is that even after week of exposure to the atmosphere, the slurry does not attract flies and worms. Thank you, Jai Hind.